Hello and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, what I'd like to do for you tonight is let you know what you get in the box with this. This is Guild Academies of Valeria, the latest Valeria game from Daily Magic Games. Now, I know a lot of people get confused because you hear about all kinds of different Valeria games. Each Valeria game is a standalone game. This is a standalone competitive board game for 1 to 5 players, play times up to 2 hours. This is a game all about teaching in schools, in a magical school, in a magical world, where you are recruiting students and using your professors and building your academy to send your students out in the world to complete quests. It is a very different theme from the other Valeria games, but it is a standalone game. You don't need to know anything else about Valeria. But if you are a Valeria fan, which I am, full disclosure here, I am a Valeria fanboy. I love their stuff. First discovered, what is the card game? Valeria Card Kingdoms at Origins, and met the Mico there and fell in love. And their color is purple, and they gave us purple nerds, and they won me over by giving me purple nerds. So I'm easy to bribe. I do also have to thank them. This is a review copy, so thank you, Daily Magic Games, for that. So I'm about to crack open a shiny new copy of Guild Academies of Valeria and let you know what you get inside the box. Step one, of course, will be to remove the shrink wrap. So now that I moved in a bit, you can kind of see it. Here is the copy of the game. I'll quickly show you the back of the box, which kind of walks through everything, the contents and the information, which I already basically told you. You can tell this is going to be a very busy board. But what I want to show you is what's inside. So we're going to crack this open. This is my first time opening this. I have not played this game. Well, I do have an idea of how the game is played. I did a little research before opening this box. I have not played this game. I have watched a video. I do have some idea of how it's played. So I mainly did that so I can describe the various components in the game to you while I'm doing this unboxing video. But I have not played this, so please don't consider anything I'm talking about a rule teach. Now, this is unique and interesting. I don't know if these are promos or bonuses, but the box inserts on top of everything. So we do have a baggie, one for your professors. Yes, the professors look a little bonkers. And one for your students, which are dice in this game. This is a dice drafting game. Here we have some quests. I don't know if this is all the quests in the game, but these are the quests you would send your students on. So we're going to show off these cards because they were on top. Very reminiscent of Shadow Kingdoms of Valeria, which is another dice game by them. You're going to recognize, if you know Valeria games, the iconography here, right? This is convert 2 blue dice into 2 magic and 3 victory points. I know that because I played many of their games. It's one of the things I appreciate from Daily Magic. So these are the various quests in the game. I don't know if these are bonus quests or why they're separate on top. So we have a bunch of quests. We're going to slide those back in. Those go in nice. We have a bag of baggies, always appreciated. Then we have the Castellan Dock action. So this looks like summary cards. So this is a mix of drafting and worker placement. So yes, these are the various dock actions. Each has its own card, so that's an interesting way to do it. And then the various phases. So instead of one card that summarizes everything, there are 4 main worker placement spots in this game, and well, there's a card for each of them. It's an interesting way to do it. I appreciate it. Some of them actually, you win by this. End game scoring. No, page left blank. I'm amused by that. The restoration phase. Appreciate it. And again, the box insert here was on top. There we have all the stuff. It's kind of a loose mess once you get inside, I see. So we're going to put these over to the side. We're going to start with the board. There are the rules. So the board's above the rules. Okay, it's not quite as big as I thought it might be. Ugh. So, this is the board. You can see it here. It's a nice, very colorful board, very clear. You got your worker placement spots where the quests go. These are like the, it's hard to hold up. So these are basically the patrons, like the important people, the people up in the ivory tower that you can petition to get abilities. You got a scoring track. You got place to store your purple buildings, place to store your green buildings. You've got various tracks here where you're going to get bonuses. Quests are going to go in here, your people to recruit, and your worker placement spots. Again, if you know Valeria, you're going to recognize the symbols. Valeria has 4 guilds. Of course, your students come from those 4 guilds. single-sided board. Done. Rule book. I have always been impressed by all of the Daily Magic rule books, though this one looks like someone cut a chunk off it, which just looks weird. That's fine on the inside. Whew, that's some small text. Okay, I usually like the rule book. They went a little tiny on this one. I wish the font was a little bigger. Component overview, game flow overview, recruitment phase, something I do appreciate. Note, they're color-coded. So the overview's red, the recruitment phase is all yellow, or sorry, orange, and then when you get into the education phase, it's in yellow. You've got some artwork scattered in here. You've got all the Valeria symbols. Okay. What's this? Okay, there's a summary. Okay, why this feels like it should open. So there's like a little summary two-page thing right in the middle. Oh, this is the solo rules. Okay, fair. Solo rules is a separate little pamphlet. I dig that. That's a nice touch. Bonus points. Questing phase. Restoration phase. End game scoring. And then, of course, appendices. They've always been very good for that, explaining every card, every possible building, and so on. All right. Looks good. Wooden bits. We'll get to those in a minute, because I'm going to put this off to the side. More wooden bits. So many wooden bits. Yep. More wooden bits. Dice. Four guilds. Four colors of dice. I'll show off one of each in a minute. This is why the box insert was on top. Look at all that cardboard. You are probably not going to want to do what I'm doing where stuff's falling out. You're going to want those baggies that I showed you earlier available to start bagging this stuff. So these are the various buildings you can build because you're building your academy. They should be single-sided, which I just confirmed. Yep, single-sided. This is part of one player board, so the individual player boards are puzzle fit. So this is one half. I'm going to keep this aside so I can kind of show you. Various monument tokens. These are some kind of bonus tokens you can draft. This is the same side of a board. Is it not? Oh, they're actually different player colors. So I just noticed this is the yellow. It's more of a yellowy green. And this is the purple. So I'm just going to go through these quickly. Because there's not a lot to show off. All the different buildings you can build in the game. These are places you would send your students and your professors to get rewards during the game. There's the other blue. Both halves of the blue now. Now we should start getting into. So these are city buildings that, again, have various different abilities you can use. And they're all keyed to the different guilds. Red. Where was the other half of the yellow? Did I go by it? I think I went by it. Let's find the other half of the yellow. Blue, purple, there it is. Just so I can show an assembled board here. Come on. There. Punches pretty easily. I got buildings falling out left and right. So this is one player's player board. And you're going to track your gold and magic here. Your students are going to go here and your academy is going to build up above it. So that shows the kind of player area. So then we have the purple buildings are endgame scoring buildings. Then, interestingly, instead of summary cards, I'm going to punch one of these. You got a summary cardboard, an actual, I'd like that. And then a summary of the recruitment phase. So very cool. I like that. That is nice. So we're going to toss all this cardboard back in here. There you go. All the cardboard components. I'm going to end up making it so the box doesn't close. So then we have the rest of this stuff. So let's get all this out of the way for now. We're going to put the board back. This on top, maybe? Let's get this out of here so we can look at the rest of the stuff. The rest of the stuff. Torches. We have torch symbols in the four player colors. Interesting to note, your four player colors here are colorblind friendly. That's why they're not what you're used to seeing. You're looking at a purple, a burgundy, teal and an olive are your three colors. These are silkscreened, but I will note only on one side. So torches. I don't know if there's a word for meeple torches. Torcheeples? No, that's lame. These are your, I can't remember what they're called. These are your workers. I forget what they're called. Your academics that you send out to the worker placement spots. What I thought was interesting is they're actually unique. So in addition to the colors being different on these in particular, they're actually different symbols on each of them as well. So you should have three of these per player color. Sorry, I forget the name of that specific component. Then we have, let's stick with player pieces. These are your flags or banners. These represent when you petition one of the, again, the ivory tower, the representatives, the guild representatives at the top of the board. You can have at most three that you are working with. And again, there are three of each of these in three colors. And again, besides colors, they also have different symbols on them. Then we have round scoring markers, same deal, the four player colors and with those symbols on them. Again, silk screened, but only on one side, which is fine. They're going to lay flat. Oh, wait, there are three of these in each color. So sorry, I apologize. Those obviously aren't the scoring markers. These big cubes are the scoring markers. These have to be for other tracks. I apologize. I'm not sure exactly which tracks because, again, I haven't played this yet. Then we have gold and mana trackers for each of the players, a round tracker, and a first player token. These are going to look familiar to anyone who's played any of Valeria games because the gold symbol is a orange disc and the mana symbol is like a rounded blue triangle, which is the same as it is in all of their games. Again, one of the things I dig. Then we get to one of the fun parts that I thought is the crazy looking professors with their wild hair. These are all going to go in a bag, and they are professors for each of the guilds in the game. So these are going to match the color of the dice, not the player colors. And again, they are silk screened on one side and do feature slightly different artwork to be able to differentiate them. So there's a bunch of these because these are going to get drawn from the bag because different professors, you never know which are going to be available. Then we get to the final component in Guild Academies of Valeria, and these are the dice. And what these have, it's really simple. It's the numbers 1 through 6 in color with the guild symbol they represent. So if I remember, red is the warrior guild. I'm not going to pull out a die of each of these. I don't see a reason for it. Blue is the religious faction. Then we have the workers, the hammers, and the final guild, the Shadow Guild. I like to call them thieves in gray. Colors are all very distinct, but again, I appreciate this. If someone has a rarer form of color blindness, it doesn't work for these particular colors. The symbols are on every die. So you don't have to remember that the Shadow Guild dice are gray. Now, these dice represent your students. You're going to get your students whatever level they are. You're trying to level them up through education to get them to turn to a 7. No to die can't turn to 7. Once they do that, they've graduated, you're then going to send them out on quests. Quests will give you victory points and more resources. That's the kind of gist of the game in a very high-level overview. So what I am hoping to do, this was my theory, is I would be able to put these just in here. And it looks like that's going to work. So yeah, very odd to see a box insert on top. Box insert on top of all the cardboard. You just don't see that. It's kind of interesting. I like it. There you go. That's pretty much it. Ta and da. What you get in the box for Guild Academies of Valeria, the latest Valeria game from Daily Magic Games. It's a dice drafting game. Reminds me a bit of Shadow Kingdoms with the dice, but it does not use the same type of dice. It does have some of the same mechanics, but we're not here to talk about mechanics. You're going to build your own academy in this game. You're using a puzzle fit board and then building square building tiles on top of that while trying to use worker placement to draft new students and take actions. Really fascinating looking game. I'm really looking forward to trying this out. Impressed by the component quality here. Everything looked great. Awesome looking little meeples. Silk screened. Only on one side, but I appreciate it. Silk screened. Well cut boards. Awesome artwork, as always, by the Mico. Love Miko's artwork. It's something to me that makes the Valeria game stand out. Now, again, this is a standalone game that's part of notice they made Valeria a lot smaller on the box. They're starting to learn that people are getting confused. They hear Valeria and think they're expansions. No. Standalone game about having your students, teaching students, sending them off on quests. Thank you, Daily Magic, for sending us a review copy. I am looking forward to this. Now, when I do end up playing Guild Academies of Valeria, I will be sharing information on it on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, where we'll talk about it in the Bellhop's Tabletop segment when we talk about all the games we play every week. Eventually, we'll do a full review of this game after we've gotten enough plays in to be comfortable with it. And that review will also be posted on YouTube, and I'll be sure to drop links on all our social media. So our social media account is Tabletop Bellhop. Pretty much every social media platform out there, we're there. If you're on one and we're not, give me a DM on one of the ones we are on so that I can join it, because I want to be everywhere. Other than that, you will be able to find more of our stuff at tabletopbellhop.com. So thank you for joining me for this unboxing. That's all I've got to say for now on Guild Academies of Valeria from Daily Magic Games.